engaged in child trafficking that's been disguised as adoption. Children snatched from their families, declared orphans, and then put up for adoption for sale to families across the world. The kids are gone, but those left behind have lived to tell their tale.
18-year-old Renuka stays with her grandparents. Three of Renuka's younger sisters have been given in foreign adoption to an Italian couple by Pune-based adoption agency Preet Mandir. The fourth, who is HIV positive, is at a child welfare home in Pandharpur. When their father signed the letter allowing Preet Mandir to put them up for adoption, he wasn't told what he was doing.
Kalyani Nagar wale aaye aur phir bole ki kitne hai to dekhe to char hai papa ne bola char ki sahi nahi karke bachcho ko leke gaye
aap kabhi Kalyani Nagar nahi
gaye gaye the do baar hi gaye the
to kya bolte hain wo aapko
theek hai acche karke hi bole the do baar mile uske baad mama gaya to wo bole acche karke aap baar baar mat aao bachche log ye hote disturb hote phir rone lagte iske waste mat aao bole
J.S. Bhaseen, who runs Preet Mandir, has been previously exposed by a CNN-IBN investigation for procuring and selling children to foreign parents illegally for thousands of dollars. Renuka's case shows that J.S. Bhaseen's child trafficking network has deep roots in Maharashtra. At Preet Mandir, Renuka's sisters were declared orphans and freed them for foreign adoption.
बोले कि अच्छा पढ़ाएंगे लिखाएंगे बड़ा करेंगे ऐसा लेके इसके वास्ते हमने डाला उधर.
While CARA guidelines say siblings should be kept together as far as possible, the family court in Pune conveniently forgot to mention Renuka in this court order. Even CARA was quick to furnish this no objection certificate to Preet Mandir, Nikita, Komal and Ashwini to be put up for adoption.
इसके लिए पापा के दस्तखत लिए के पापा को तो पढ़ने को नहीं आता था.
After Renuka's mother died, Preet Mandir got her father to sign this consent letter.
I have everything in my house. I can provide for them, but I can't do without them.
Her parents are dead and four sisters gone. A few photographs is all Renuka has to live with.
Our next stop was Buldhana.
Bhai ka naam kya tha?
जप्पी.
जप्पी कितनी बड़ी थी? तुमसे छोटी थी बड़ी थी?
इतनी.
9-year-old Vishal misses his younger sister Priyanka. Time has come to a stop for this mother and her young son. Lakshmi kept her baby girl Priyanka at Love Trust, a child care center in Buldhana.
क्यों नहीं मिलेंगी मेरी बच्ची मेरे को वापस? मैंने सिर्फ संभालने के लिए दी थी कि मेरी ऐसी हालत नहीं थी कि उसको संभालू करके.
This relinquishment deed freed Priyanka for adoption. She is not an orphan. Her mother, father and brother are still alive. Our investigation then approached the owners of Love Trust and the trustees simply cited CARA guidelines.
The period of 2 months that they can again claim the baby. Because our basic aim, as I told you, is adoption of the baby. What can we just keep the baby in the orphanage?
For Lakshmi, the scars are yet to heal. Battling with 75% burn injuries, after her husband set her on fire, she put her daughter for temporary care at what she was told is a child care center.
Instead of calling it an orphanage, we call it a child care center because an orphanage carries a different impression.
Orphanage or adoption home? The fine print is never made clear.
Some doubt if enough was done to find adoptive parents for the child in India.
Lakshmi Solanki ki bachchi jo thi Priyanka wo healthy thi. Usko pure Maharashtra mein koi lene wala nahi tha. पूरे भारत देश में कोई लेने वाला नहीं था. विदेश में भेजने का काम क्या?
We then traveled to Karhad and met Kisabai Lokhande, who had kept her granddaughters Ashwini and Komal at the observation home in Satara. She soon discovered that her girls had been moved to Preet Mandir.
When I met them in Pune, my granddaughter said, "They're taking good care of us. Don't worry." The Preet Mandir people said, "Don't worry about your granddaughters. Don't keep coming again and again."
Preet Mandir then put out this newspaper notice, giving her 30 days to reclaim her grandchildren, failing which they would be given up in adoption. Preet Mandir knew Kisabai would never see the ad.
I sent them there so that they could go to school, not for them to be sent abroad.
But Ashwini and Komal have gone, sold to a foreign couple in Spain who don't know they were gone by child traffickers. की सभा इज डिटर्मिन टू वॉक एनी लेंथ टू गेट द गर्ल्स बैक.
मला आठवण येते, मला जेवण.
आय मिस देम अ लॉट. आय हैव लॉस्ट माय एपेटाइट एंड आय कीप फॉलिंग इल. आय डू एनीथिंग टू गेट देम बैक.
Poverty and illiteracy are endemic in the Marathwada region of Maharashtra. It is a potent combination that makes this a preferred hunting ground for the baby snatchers.
When Govind's parents died of HIV, his Anganwadi teacher took him to the child welfare home in Parbhani.
जो प्रीत मंदिर वाले हैं उनको बुला लिए और उनको फिर उसके साथ दे दिए. अभी उन्होंने क्या बोले कि तुम अभी 5-6 महीने आना मत बोले इसको देखने के लिए. अगर आप आएंगे तो वो पीछे लगेगा और फिर आने का बोलेगा, इसलिए आप मत आइए. इसलिए मैं गई नहीं वहाँ पर.
Within months, Govind was transferred to Preet Mandir and sold to an Italian couple.
अभी वो तो बड़े होंगे ना इटली वाले लोग. हमको साल में से एक बार अगर लाकर भी उन्होंने दिखा दिए तो बस है. हमको खाली बड़ा उन्हें बड़े बड़ा हुए हुआ मेरे को देखने का है, इतनी मेरी कामना है.
The Parbhani police told us that Govind's adoption papers were found to be in place and that his uncle did not respond within the 30-day notice period.
Govind ke jo chacha the unhone application diya tha ki mere bhatije ko foreign mein becha gaya hai. Uske wo application ke zariye hum fir puri tehqeeqat kar li. To court ke mutabik court order ke mutabik to usko adopt kar diya hai.
Govind's uncle alleges his thumb impression was taken on a blank paper.
I was called to Parbhani and told to sign on blank papers and I don't know what happened after that.
And did he read Preet Mandir's notice in the newspaper?
I cannot read and write, so how will I see the newspaper?
Ek pattern dikhai diya hai ki ek to anpadh log hai jinse angutha lena easy rehta hai, bachon ka admission karana hai, school mein bhejna hai iske naam pe, to easily wo mil jata hai. अब जो पढ़े लिखे जिनको मराठी आता है थोड़ा बहुत, तो जिस ढंग से उनसे वो सिग्नेचर लिया जाता है तो पेरेंट्स को कुछ सोचने का मौका ही नहीं दिया जाता है कि किसके ऊपर क्या क्या लिखा है, क्या नहीं लिखा, हम क्यों सिग्नेचर कर रहे हैं, ये सोचने का मौका ही नहीं दिया जाता है.
The investigation traveled from Maharashtra to Andhra Pradesh looking for families tricked into relinquishing their children. In Medak district we met Lakshmi. Both her daughters were trafficked to the US 8 years ago by one Sanjeeva Rao.
It was Sanjeeva Rao. He gave the children away. I only sent them to school. Later, people said I sold my kids for money and insulted me.
Sanjeeva Rao's racket has since been busted. Lakshmi was lucky to trace her daughter's adoptive parents. Lakshmi now meets her daughters once in a year.
My daughter talks to me, but she doesn't know Telugu. She can say mummy, daddy, and bhaiya. She talks very nicely.
But Lakshmi's America-raised daughters have now outgrown her.
She doesn't stay with us. She stays till 10 at night and then leaves.
Sister Teresa Maria was responsible for over 500 illegal adoptions uncovered in 2001, after which Andhra Pradesh placed a ban on foreign adoptions. Fatima was one of her victims. Unable to pay for her cesarean operation, Teresa kept her baby as collateral.
Sister, wo church wala sister hai na, Teresa Maria. उन्हों बेच ले सो सिस्टर मर गए फातिमा बोले कहते तुम्हारे मम्मी मर गए बच्ची को अनुशक बोले कहते साइन करो तो मैं अंगूठी डाली तो बाद में बच्ची कायम बोल के उनको पूछे तो तू साइन करे ना मैं बच्ची दे दी बोली मम्मी पहले से.
And Fatima could never have a child again. She had been sterilized.
ऑपरेशन का उन्हें गीटी मार दी सिस्टर बच्चादाना का गीटी डाल दिए बच्चा नहीं हुआ ये सरकार जब से नहीं हुआ रहेंगे.
Her daughter Anusha lives with her adopted family in Germany. Internet activism and a DNA test match the mother and daughter. Fatima hopes when Anusha grows older, she will come back to meet her.
आप बड़ी नहीं है ना, छोटी बच्ची का है ना, बड़ी हुई तो उम्र का आ सकते हैं. उन क्या बोल सकती हूँ बच्ची?
My name is Alina. I'm 7 and 8.
All these 28 girls are stuck at Teresa's tender loving care home. Caught in a 6-year stalemate. Sister Teresa won't allow Indian couples to adopt them. The Andhra state government won't let them go to foreign families.
For these 28 children, we are given 50-52 babies are given for national. This is all rejected children.
Yeah.
Italy, Spain, Germany, US mean nothing to these parents who would give anything to be reunited with their children. After the break, we reveal how the regulatory bodies that are supposed to monitor foreign adoptions often cover up and facilitate those involved in child trafficking.
झूठ बोलते हो
सीबीआई कभी नहीं
कभी इसलिए आए उसकी मुलाकात पर नहीं हुई
मैं वो स्ट्रीट मंदिर पेंग फॉर योर स्टे
इन पुणे दिस इज टोटली फॉल्स
And compromise. 1 year after a CNN IBM special investigation exposed malpractice at the Pune-based Street Mandir, the adoption agency continues to curry favor and flourish with the blessings of the very regulatory body that should be restraining it.
This is J.S. Paseen, the owner of Street Mandir, putting a price tag on babies up for adoption. After the June 2000 CNN-IBN expose into child trafficking under the guise of adoption, the CBI was asked to investigate the matter. The CBI, with its findings, has relied on testimonies of unwed mothers, saying they willingly handed over their babies for adoption. But one such mother says she was never questioned by the CBI.
सीबीआई कभी नहीं
कभी इसने आए उसकी मुलाकात पर नहीं हुई कहले उसने बच्चे लिया कुछ पूछा नहीं कुछ नहीं
The Maharashtra government had initially recommended the suspension of Preet Mandir's foreign adoption license after confirming that extra donations taken from foreign parents had not been documented. But 3 months later, the Maharashtra Women and Child Welfare Department did a strange U-turn, saying they found no evidence of child trafficking or sale of children outside the adoption process. This home for unwed mothers in Talegaon, exposed as a source of cheap babies to sell abroad, not only got a clean sheet, but was also commended for its welfare work. The cover-up was complete in January 2007, when Dr. Jagannath Pati from the Central Regulatory Authority, CARA, visited Preet Mandir, only to say that he found no cases there of babies being snatched from biological parents or of foreign couples being preferred to Indian adoptive parents.
At no point did the CBI or the Maharashtra government or CARA ask this investigation for the documents in its possession that showed how adoption agencies were involved in child trafficking. Yet, the agencies involved have been given clean chits.
Children were in waiting for adoption. We have given them this conditional license so that those children could be put up in adoption.
This is how the Central Adoption Resource Agency or CARA chairperson returned Preet Mandir its foreign adoption license, which was suspended after a CNN-IBN expose in 2006. This special investigation now has evidence to show that Mittal has a vested interest in allowing Preet Mandir and its owner J.S. Paseen to function. This hotel bill is small, just 16,000 rupees. But why was CARA chairperson J.K. Mittal's two-day stay in Pune funded by Preet Mandir and not the government?
Why was Preet Mandir paying for your stay in Pune?
This is totally false. I have paid my own bill.
Is this bill concocted?
Yes, it may be, yes.
It may be or it is?
It is.
Mittal gave this investigation a copy of an 11,000 rupee bill, which he says he paid the hotel.
But this investigation has confirmed that this receipt of 11,000 rupees is only a record of a discount given by the hotel on this original bill of 16,000 rupees, which was settled by Preet Mandir through a credit card account. The CARA advocate is in possession of both the bills.
We also found that in October 2007, just ahead of its international conference, CARA published this list of recognized adoption agencies in national newspapers, careful to leave out Preet Mandir's name.
That may be an omission. To avoid any controversy, the name was not included in this list.
But strangely, Preet Mandir is listed as an active adoption agency in these CARA booklets meant only for internal circulation. Not only is Preet Mandir still in business, it also continues to manage Shishu Sadan, a government-owned adoption home in Aurangabad. Licensed to place children for adoption only within India, Shishu Sadan was used by Preet Mandir as a source for children to traffic abroad. But Shishu Sadan denies links with Preet Mandir.
This is a Shishu Sadan program only. And Preet Mandir is added because, in our name, because it is a caretaking institution. This is not a brand.
A close look at Shishu Sadan's certificate of recognition revealed that its license number and the exact date of issue was missing, which the official in charge refused to explain.
I will not show. I will not tell.
The Women and Child Department in Pune attribute the blanks to a clerical error.
Omissions, deletions, corruption and compromise. Dubious adoption agencies not only have a well-oiled machinery to traffic babies abroad, it is now clear they breach the system so that it looks the other way. How is CARA going to clean up the adoption processes in the country when it is a willing partner in the cover-up?
If I am giving you 50 lakhs, I understand that 6 babies are coming to me this year. It's like per baby, so much money.
Misinformation violates the rights of the biological parents of the child and the adopted parents. And yet, adoption is crucial for thousands of destitute children. So it is important to look for solutions to make the process more transparent and free from racketeers.
Chaya Maria Shuk is 31. She's come from Germany looking for her birth mother from Mangalore.
She was a good mother. She takes very care for me. She was a single mother. I don't know about my father.
Chaya spent the first 7 years of her life with her Indian mother before a German family adopted her. Chaya is still to find her mother.
In my case, we have no record. I cannot believe it. I spent so lots of money every time to come to India, my flight ticket, to stay in India. And it's not nice. India is for me no holiday.
Single and unwed mothers are most vulnerable to child traffickers. With support, many of them could raise their children themselves.
They should be for, I think, all single, unwed mothers, separated mothers or fathers. There should be some kind of support system like there is in the West.
No adoption agency should run an unwed mother's home. Doing so creates a conflict of interest as the agency is directly interested in acquiring a child for adoption. There is also the issue of dubious grants from international agencies that come in the form of humanitarian aid.
If I am giving you 50 lakhs, I understand that 6 babies are coming to me this year. It's like per baby, so much money.
Such aid is often indirect, illegal payments for babies that must be curbed.
Let them pay the money, whatever money they have to pay to the placement agency or anybody else in the process, let them pay to the district treasury and get the challan and produce it to the placement agency.
Not just payments, adoption agencies in India just have to get more transparent about several issues.
The agency should put up a declaration or a white paper every month as to how these adoptions have taken place, how many relinquishment papers are there, what kind of medical records were produced, and they should be accountable to the public.
But foreign adoption itself need not be discouraged, as there are some children with no takers within India.
Very rarely Indian family will ever consider adopting a child whose mother was tested HIV positive. But there are many cases where foreigners simply ignore it.
Of scrutiny agencies also needs to be re-examined if malpractices in adoptions is to be avoided.
I would really strongly recommend that the whole thing should be decentralized at the district administrative level. Free for adoption is a right of the child welfare committee, but we know that quite a few placement agencies are bypassing the responsibility of the child welfare committee. They are not producing the surrendered children to the to the Child Welfare Committee at all.
With Tara now promising to quicken further adoption, who will ensure that families are not being broken up by dubious adoption agencies? Who will bring such child traffickers to book? When will the system become transparent and corruption-free? For the sake of these children, it's best we remain optimistic. Thanks for watching.